Lost relics of the ancient world, 3,000 years ago. Using a state-of-the-art rover, archaeologists from Hubbabard University have breached the silence of a long-sealed chamber in the ruins of a site researchers have aptly named Gobakitumbo.
Keep going. Keep going. Wait. Wait, what's that?
What mysteries of the old world lie buried by time?
Right there. Move there.
What they discovered may perhaps change our understanding of antiquity forever.
My God.
This civilization was far more advanced than any of our original notions. An empire dedicated to the arts, to the divine, but also to the sciences.
The researchers have uncovered a scroll, what may be a diploma of high academic achievement.
These people, the breadth of their study, they may have unlocked knowledge greater than we possibly could have imagined. Perhaps greater than the Library of Alexandria.
I believe we're looking at some sort of canned food or meat.
They had brilliant techniques of preservation. These people didn't waste a thing.
Idols, suggesting a deep and devout religious fervor.
They had a complex system of belief, a polytheistic pantheon. There was a trickster deity, a god of science, demigods even, men made from iron.
There were at least three Iron Men.
We're still having trouble translating their hieroglyphics. Their language was so complex.
The terms goon or jelk, these are both nouns, verbs, sometimes adjectives, used in everyday speech, yet their meanings lost to time.
Perhaps terms of affection. I goon you. Have a nice jelk.
Many ancient tablets reveal mystic secrets.
Tablets of Roku, of Kindle, of Amazon Fire. These were the spells they would cast in their time. Of course, what we now call science.
This sock is perfectly fossilized.
Some mysteries remain unsolved.
The apple was certainly confusing. We theorize either it was lightly cooked on the top to increase its flavor, or it was used in an incense-burning ritual to speak with spirits on the other side. Either way, it was perfectly preserved, just like this flower.
A warrior culture, one of bravery and litigious acumen.
One folk hero by the name of Saul, they would invoke him or call upon Saul's name in times of dire need. That's Dobby from Harry Potter.
Their entire class system was centered around the hoarding of symbolic totems or trinkets.
Essentially, they would wear their money on their shoes.
This man was clearly a king.
I feel like we have only just scratched the surface. We have so much to learn from our ancient past.
What's wrong? It's not responding.
Some secrets remain hidden, but others will soon see the light of discovery.
Unfortunately, the rover suffered a catastrophic failure when its treads got stuck on a busty anime mouse pad, and it spun into a fragile yet structurally significant cup of Baja Blast.
We gotta get in there.
Luckily, it captured one final image, and it is breathtaking.
Have a nice jelk. Perhaps greater than the Library of Alexandria.
This is Dobby from Harry Potter.